our anyway, it's a long story, never mind. Oh, that's elephant, elephant. Sorry. The song has rules. Anytime we say a word that either is or rhymes with elephant, you repeat the word. Elephant,
elephant.
Big and strong and gentle and intelligent.
Intelligent.
How could I feel blue? I've got my sister at my side and an elephant to ride. Oh, elephant,
elephant.
You're sat in a cage, but that's irrelevant.
Irrelevant.
Cause everyone is jealous when they see me riding high on a friend of such great size. Other kids have bikes,
that's true.
Or daddies pick them up from school.
That won't do for me, you understand.
Understand.
Other kids have horses.
Other kids have dogs.
Other kids have hamsters.
Other kids have frogs. But for me is something much more grand.
And elegant.
And benevolent.
And democratic.
That's a plan. And independent.
Independent.
And I've got an elephant.
Elephant.
Riding on your back, I'm in my element.
Element.
It's true and it's a fact, there is so much you can learn when you're on a pachyderm. Oh, elephant.
Elephant.
It's not so bad, it's swell of it to give me such a friend. Oh, elephant.
Elephant.
I'm with you to the end. Oh, elephant.
Elephant.
Elephant. I'm with you to the end. I wanted to play one of the songs from this project I did a year and a half ago about the daughter of one of Everett's founders. How many of you saw the thing or the book? I don't want to try to tell the whole story right now because it's really long. It took me about a year to tell it. But in short, by a kind of miraculous chain of circumstances, actually, Amanda was here visiting me, asked me, what's up with Rucker? And I didn't know, and I took her to the Weird Pyramid, and the next day I was in San Francisco by chance, a friend of mine heard I lived in Everett, and was like, I need to show you something, and he shows me this scrapbook he'd found in a dumpster 20 years earlier that happened to be the life story of a woman born in Everett, Washington, that he fell in love with, kept for ages. The woman, her name was Margaret Rucker, daughter of Bethel Rucker, one of the brothers that pretty much founded this town. But more so than the crazy coincidences, her life was dark, beautiful. She wrote poetry. And anyway, this is a song I wrote for that project. Kind of thinking about what it would be like to grow up in a town where the streets are named after you and where you look up on the top of the hill and there's a giant tomb that has your name on it in which you'll eventually be entombed. And wondering what that would be like, and wondering what one would think if years later someone pulled your life story out of the trash and sang songs about it. Anyway. Coming down this river, You've been watching so much longer now than I. Do you know, Ma, just what will the day deliver? Does it work out tooth for tooth, eye for eye? They started stacking up the stones the very day that you were born. No matter how you grew, they would tower above you. You could change your name, move all the way to sunny California. When you start your life anew, does that long shadow follow you? Who was it, Margaret, that chose to resurrect you here for me? In scattered lines of poetry, this distant wistful girl I see reflected in your eyes. Forgive me, Margaret, all the ways I am mistaken, all the liberties I've taken. I've projected you in costumes I don't think were quite your size. Here I'm climbing up these stones 100 years after you were born, looking for a song that could take me to you. I could change my name, move all the way to sunny California. Man, I screwed it up. I've traced these roads to past your home in Burbank, California. You were not inside. You found a different place to hide. Tell me, Margaret, when I'm gone, what will I want to be left at the bottom of a garbage bin, or dusted up, pulled up onto stage? Will it please me when someone lights a candle and says my name? Will I say, leave me in my pyramid, blow out the flame, close the lid? This story's done, why don't we turn the page? This next song, it's not about dogs or cats either, but it does have a part that I thought might appeal to the dogs and cats in us. It's about the moon. And whenever I mentioned moon, I thought perhaps...
Moon!
Something like that. And when I'm not mentioning moon, you can feel free to stomp and clap and scream and Things will feel more awesome if that's better. No pressure. Last time my days I've drowned mine, so I've run campaigns against the light. I've been the light, and if I died down, I shrunk back from the fact that I've got this feeling, this suspicion, this heart mentioned something, something, and I'm lifting my feet to take a step. I'm ready. Set change colors in the lead, and let the wind come shake me down. Deliver me closer to the night. I made a promise to the moon. Little box cars.